Okay, all right. How's the voice? Let's turn it down a little bit. Maybe maybe like here-ish. Turn down the volume a little bit here. That should work. Okay, maybe make this a little bit louder. Okay, let's play some songs. Stream's looking all right. Things looking fine. What's up, Lomog? How you doing? I think I'll start with some Floyd. What do you think of that?
Learn a song.
We'll go with them apples. I can play this and... Nah, we're not doing that. Okay, where are you, Floyd? It's been a while, right? I haven't played guitar in like a month? Month and a half on stream, so... Warm up, shall we? That one's pretty good. I'm thinking Comfortably Numb. If I can get to it. There we go. Yeah, that's it.
Ooh, have become comfortably numb. I
think I'm tuned, right? Oh, Black Sabbath? You could do that one too.
Is there anyone home?
What's up, Dr. Quack? How you doing? Are you comfortably numb?
Come on, it's time to go.
See if I have it.
You are overcome in words. Your lips move.
I can't
hear right. What you say. When I was a child, I thought of you doing good.
Is that buzzing me or is that in the recording? I think that's in the recording. No, that's me. Wow. Oh, thank you, Dougie McQuacks. I'm gonna see if I got the Lady Evil on Black Sabbath. Then I'll see if I have Black Midi. I can check both right now so that, you know, you're not stuck waiting. Alright, let's see. Let's check the first one. I do not have Black Midi though. Lady Evil. You can request another one if you want to, as long as I have it. Alright, what's E flat? Yeah, continue without tuning.
We'll be right back.
improv the solo a little bit. It was better than trying to play it. All right, Dougie McQuacks, I don't have Black MIDI. If you got another request, let me know if you're still here. If not, I'm gonna go play more Black Sabbath. Let me turn this up a little bit. Is this loud enough? I don't want it too loud, because then all you hear is like string noise. Alright, I played Dio Sabbath. I guess I'll play Into the Void. That one's pretty good. Oh man, you know what really kicks though from Black Sabbath? I remember the song. I think it's Supernaut. Yeah, this one. All right, C sharp standard. I think down 3. Check. Yep. Down. This song just kicks, man. I love the drums in it.
Yeah. you.
I also want to play some Offspring. I'm feeling the Offspring. But not the stuff that like people normally hear from Offspring, you know? What's up, Thumper? How are you doing? All right, we're doing... I'll do Ozzy's Paranoid, and then I'll do, like, a Dio thing. Since we're stuck in the Black Sabbath... Black Sabbath connects the Dio and the Ozzy. Oh, wait, there he is. Okay, wait. Like, I got the air conditioning on. The house only gets to, like, 86. And, like, that's it. Usually it gets to 82. In that guitar sound with that JCM 800. So here he kind of made it like too loud. Like, the guy who made the song made it a little too twangy, but that's what's neat about Randy, is he used a lot of... he kind of kept the same sound, he just dropped it down a little bit to make it slightly heavier. And then he added, like, a little bit more chorus to it. Especially if you hear the isolated Randy tracks that people have found, like, over the years, right? Like, Ozzy listening to Randy soloing. It's pretty amazing, like, just how clean he could play. All right, Dio. It's either going to be Rainbow in the Dark. You know what? It's going to be Rainbow in the Dark. That one's like, I like Holy Diver, but I feel like Rainbow in the Dark is like, that's his crazy train, if you know what I mean. Maybe I need to recalibrate again. It sounds like I'm getting a lot of, like, background noise. I guess I'll do that.
Excellent performance.
Bear with me on that. I gotta like, play a power chord for, like, 2 minutes. Well, not really. That's an exaggeration. Should only take, like, about a minute. Oh, wait. No, that's the wrong button. There we go. Let me just calibrate this thing here. All right, that should do it. I had to let my roadies go. I had to let them run free. Oh, you know what happened? I was streaming, and then one of my roadies, he forgot to adjust this one little thing, and then I just cursed him out for 30 minutes on stream, like Ingrid Malmsteen style. I'm like, what the fuck are you doing, man? Well, do I look like a clown to you? What the hell? Song request, You Could Be Mine? Okay. Guns N' Roses? And then I refused to go on stage. I just walked off.
Learn a song.
All right, okay. It's going to die. Okay, the live version or the record version? I'm going to go with the live version. It sounds more like Axel. He messed up that one little thing by like a centimeter, and that just fucked up everything. It uses low bass? Yeah, it's tuned down a half step. I got a pedal. Wait, let me get this thing going here. I can't. Let me try to get this knob here. Okay, there we go. Let me just bend over and get it. Oh, my back. Ah, there we go. Perfect. Excellent. Oh, I gotta turn it on too, that helps. Awesome, here we go. Wasn't this like the Terminator music video? Looks at Axel and, like, you know, his target threat thing is, like, not worth my time. We'll be right back.
video.
Few movies deliver. That's true. T2 and Aliens 2 are like the best, or Aliens is like the best sequel. He announced his next song is dedicated to a good friend of mine that passed, or something like that. Then the crowd went wild. He went ape shit on the crowd for cheering Mr. Brownstone. There's a video of Axl Rose on YouTube, and it's from a live gig, and it's the one where Slash loses his pants backstage. So Axl has to go on stage and he has to talk. He has to buy time, you know what I mean? And so his idea of buying time is he like, I forget where he's playing. I think it's like the Midwest. And he's like, oh, last time I was here. And then he goes into this like 5 or 10 minute story about how he was hitchhiking. And then he was almost sexually molested by the guy that picked him up. And that was his plan to like, yeah, I really like Cleveland. It's pretty good. And then, like, that goes on for, like, 5 or 10 minutes. And then they couldn't find Slash's pants. So then you just hear, like, the intro to, I think they play, which one is it? Well, Welcome to the Jungle. You hear the intro played wrong. Right? Because he's, like, a step down. And then the rest of the band's, like, looking at him. And then Welcome to the Jungle just starts. And then Slash plays it with no pants. Yes. And then he apologizes afterwards. He's like, I'm sorry, I got no pants. My pants broke. That's why I'm out here like AC/DC. It's like the clad. Like, that right there sums up Guns N' Roses so well. All right. I'm not making this up. You can go look it up on YouTube. Just look up Slash No Pants. You'll find that video easily. Refused to go on because the crowd. Oh, yeah, when he caused a riot in Canada. You know, this band was only together about the same, like, there are Beatles albums, like, in between a certain album and another album that lasts longer than this band was together. Oh, it's just a solo? Oh, I want to play the whole thing. I don't want to just play just the solo. Don't worry, I assume people are looking up that video of Axl screwing up. With... Here we go. Tracy and Roberta here to help us. When he says one, knock, knock, you say on one. Heaven's down. All right, here we go. Hey, 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 yeah. Knock, knock, knocking on heaven's door. Knock, knock, knocking on heaven's door. Knock, knock, knocking on heaven's door.
Knock, knock, knocking on heaven's door. Knock, knock, knocking on heaven's door.
forgot that video too. I'll look for that Slash video. I've seen it multiple times.
Top notch performance.
Oh my god, it's like I can't find it! What happened? Oh, did it get taken off? Jesus! I found the intro to it, but I can't find the whole thing. One from the early 90s Pizza Hut. Yeah, it's like a plastic cup. It's huge though. Okay, let me try to show you guys this video here. Hold on. Alright, so the only way I can do this is I'll put it on my other monitor and then I'll talk it through while it happens. But I gotta make sure I got the window right, so hold on a second. It's tough because this stream is... Alright, hey look, there's my OBS, you guys like that? Alright, here's this.
Where you are?
See, so Axel's telling the story and he's like, I was in the jungle, baby!
You know where you are? All I know is when I was here and I was 17,
I was in the middle of the fucking jungle, baby!
Then it cuts to that Slash with no pants. And he just plays the riff wrong. And then while he plays the riff wrong, the rest of the band are just looking at him. I like the ball there. And then he's like, hey man, it doesn't come in just yet. Come on, guys. It goes like this, bro. It's played totally wrong. All right. Dumpster, isn't that a good one? I guess he was distraught that he had no pants, but he still had his cigarette in his mouth, though. He's like, I still need to look cool. I'll go on stage with no pants, that's fine. That's not the whole thing. There used to be one where it was the whole thing, and it had the Axel intro, and at the end, Slash comes out, and he's like, yeah, I'm sorry, I got no pants, man. My pants broke.
Learn a song.
You know, I love Guns N' Roses, but like, there's another one. There's an MTV Live video that you can find. It's like a whole concert of MTV Live, and they're playing like shit. They are clearly fucked up. They got fucked up before the show, But they played the whole show. They went on stage and they did it. So that's a little punk rock right there. Sound like his guitar was, that could be it too. Who knows what was, he was playing it like, he was playing it lower than it should have been. And I don't know, whatever. All right, I'm gonna play Offspring now. Yeah, I wasn't making that shit up. If you can find the full video of that, it's pretty good. I pulled a slash. Hold on. My pants. All right. They wouldn't let him play live, so they all just went and played each other's instruments. What? Offspring, they're adding that third note, but they don't have to do the full one, you know, they don't have to do that with the middle finger. They can just do, like, they can just use this finger and hit both, and just not hit the last string. But yeah, Metallica does it, Black Sabbath, they have a lot of, even, like, Randy Rhoads, like, Crazy Train has that. And then, like, I was, and then, bop, 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 there it is. So, it comes and goes. Iron Man got asked to mime on live TV. They had to do that thing where they couldn't actually play. It was a pre-recorded thing, huh? So they did the thing from Airheads where they're just like, fuck it. Oh, hey, yo. Yeah, Megadeth does it too. A lot of like metal bands will do the two stringers. It was live? But it was recorded live? Well, that's even a waste of time then. Because I know for TV and shit, sometimes they do things like they have a recording and then you just pretend to play. There are bands that obviously don't do that. Like Van Halen didn't do that at all. There's the Jimmy Kimmel thing. If you guys ever heard of, like, Van Halen reunited with David Lee Roth on the Jimmy Kimmel show. And in the very beginning, David Lee Roth's doing his twirls with the microphone. And he hits himself on the nose and he breaks his nose. He starts bleeding. And so they had to cancel it for a bit. And David had to get, like, a towel and shit. And while that was going on, Van Halen and his brother, like, Eddie and Van Halen, were like, well, Eddie is Van, but you know what I mean. They were, like, just jamming out. So you could tell that they played live. Metallica's the same way, like, or even Guns N' Roses. Like, I might make fun of Slash losing his pants
Learn a song.
And them sounding like shit, but you can tell that they played live. They didn't have some backing track or some crap. Same thing with Metallica. On the BBC's flagship music program, unless they were printed, but nobody since The Who had done it live. Maiden's manager, Rod, we called, but we stuck it and said, no live, no Maiden. Yeah, exactly. Is when they took a turn singing. Oh, man. I mean, like, you know, you'll find all these bloopers of bands online and shit, but the one thing you can tell is, like, at least they had the balls to play live. They didn't use... Because they could, in this day and age, you could just put on a backing track and not play anything, right? You could just mime your whole show and no one would care. But I make the argument, then why are people watching the live show? Like, you know, the best part about, like, Iron Maiden albums, like, their live albums, is they add extra stuff. Playing drums. What's up, Joe? Whee! Alright. What's up, G-Writer? How's everyone going? How's everyone doing today? How's everyone's Tuesday? How you guys doing? I'm gonna play Offspring's... I forgot what it was called. You know what? It doesn't matter. I don't need to... Oh, kids are alright. Here we go. Play some Iron Maiden, since we're talking about Maiden. You still like it? Fair enough. Oh, here, I'll do it. I'll lip sync. You ready? I'll sound just like Dexter.
Little street.
monster. Look how small it is. What the fuck?
Top-notch performance. Guys.
Ah, okay. Well, I don't want to spoil it. That wasn't the gimmick, by the way. I guess I'll do the gimmick. So the gimmick of today is Mechasonic. What the fuck? Look, they made a toy out of the Sonic from Sonic 2. Check him out. He comes with spikes. He's not Metal Sonic, he's Mecha Sonic. He's the silver one. Like, what? Like, that's the one we got. That's it. I think that's weird. Check this guy out. Look at this guy. Like, look at Classic Sonic. Like, he's like, he's there with a spring, and he's like really fucking happy about that spring. Like, he's laughing his ass off. It's like, it's too good. Okay, he's like, oh my god, it's a spring! Wow! The world's fastest blue hedgehog, Sonic runs at ultra-high speeds and can curl into a spiky ball to protect himself and attack enemies. That's it, that's the rest is in different languages. Collect them all. What does Mechasonic say? One of the many robots modeled after Sonic, Mechasonic protects the Death Egg from all intruders. Watch out for his deadly saw blade quills! Classic Sonic. Here, I'll show. Look, I got Classic Eggman too. Check him out. He looks like a walrus. Pretty cool. All right. You know that company, that toy company? They also make the Mario toys. See, because you got like Fire Plant Mario. It's the same company. Look, it's the same box art. It's the same like crap in the back. The same company that makes Mario toys makes Sonic toys. I think it's Jax. Oh, fuck it, here's my last one. Here's my last one. All right, there he is. There's Mighty the Armadillo. I got him too. It's pretty fun. Woo. All right, enough of that. Let's play some, I did Offspring, right? So let's do
Nirvana, man, yeah.
No, I'm just kidding. Oh yeah, Iron Maiden, yeah. I need to make up an intro for this segment. I need an editor for that. Now the gimmick begins, and then I can like make an intro and an outro so I can really milk like 10 minutes of it. Fire Plant Mario is the best Mario, you gotta admit. Which one to do? We'll do the evil that men do. Like a Bill Nye suit. guess I better come clean, guys. Let's be honest here. We all know. I pre-record the streams, and then I make a bunch of dummy accounts, and then I show up in the chat while I do the pre-recorded stream, and then I just pretend to be
Wonderful
the chat, so it seems like I'm popular. Like, we all know that. We all know that I'm basically Thumper and Kirkle Beans, and I'm just... Wouldn't that be fucked up if someone did that? They did pre-record their stream. They just pretend to be their own chat. Woo! Oh, I've seen Maiden like 3 times. They always kick ass. Thumper is a paid actor. I know. I do. Well, you see, what I do is I only respond to the accounts that I'm. You know, like I set up responses and then I come back with my dummy account to purposely have the response happen. Good shit. I'm using a sound interface. I'm not using the real tone cable. I'm using the Focusrite for the guitar. And then this is just a USB mic, so. Alright, should I do Afraid? I'll be afraid to shoot. Oh wait, no, this will take forever, man. I just realized. I love that riff, but it takes forever to get to it. You can't do this with the sound interface? You mean like stream it or play it? Can you get it working with the sound interface? All you gotta do is put like 3 files in your folder. By finding like the AASIO hack or whatever. You know what? I'm gonna do, what's that one called? Flight of Icarus. I just forget what it's called. Is it just called Icarus? Yeah, the ASCO, however that's pronounced. You get the hack for that. Like, it's out there. And then you put that in your folder, and then it works. Then you gotta turn the game to non-exclusive mode. Like, there's like a setting. I don't know if it's here. Let me see. If it's actually in the menu. Audio exclusivity, you gotta turn that off. And then you should be able to stream it. Flight of Icarus. There we go. Flight of Icarus. I knew it was Icarus. The only problem with this track is that it's not very loud. That's the only thing I don't like about it. But... this one's louder, though, but why don't I play this one? There must be a reason I play this one. Why do I have 2 of them? You can only get the sound from the studio monitors connected to the sound interface. Do you have OBS set to, like, desktop sound to stream what you hear? Because that's what I do. So as long as I hear sound, I know sound's being outputted. Yeah, see like how like not loud this is? Still a good song though. Can't get the sound in OBS? Try setting your sound to like desktop audio. Can you record other stuff and not just Rocksmith? Because if you can do other stuff, then you just gotta set the audio exclusivity off.
Yeah.
play Buckethead? I can play some Buckethead. I'll do some Buckethead, and then I'll go to some Megadeth. And then I'll do some Metallica. Maybe some Sabaton if there's some time. Can't, then it's the Rocksmith thing. See, like, what you gotta do is you gotta do what I said, like, turn off the sound exclusivity in the audio menu, and then you should be able to, like, do it, because what Rocksmith does is it takes over all your sound.
Top-notch performance.
Like, if you go to here and then here, and it's turned this off, it should work. Turn that off and then maybe put the game in like a I think a borderless window. Yeah, turn on window mode. Try that one. See if that works. That's like all I got, man. Like that's probably the problem. That's 90% of the problem is that song and it just takes over everything. All right. Buckethead. Where are you, Buckethead? Dude. Yeah. I used the focus sight. It's like the cheapest one they got, like the solo one. For another interface.
last note, though. Ooh, thank you very much for that sub.
All right.
Top-notch performance.
Yeah, it's been... I don't have it. Oh, it's in the closet. I used to have it. The problem was that it would just be here, and you would just see his crotch, and it'd just be... So I put what's her face from Ghost in the Shell there. Woo! Alright. Should I do Soothsayer? I'll fuck up that intro. You guys know I will. Alright, let's do it. I haven't played guitar in a month. Let's do Soothsayer. Let's do it. Was my Soothsayer tone? Okay, cool. You have a good one, man. Thanks for hanging out. I think I'm getting the hang of this. That's the part. That's the part that messes me up every time. Soon. Here we go. Now it's done. We're done.
have to use the little pedal.
Top-notch performance.
That's the only part I gotta slow down and figure out is that tapping part near the end. He does like a sweep. It's like... He does like a sweep and then a tap. Like, it's like it's really fast. That's the one thing. The other thing, though, that part in the beginning, that's just like a jumble. Going from that one chord... So those are like the two parts that I struggle with in that. Alright, I was gonna do like Sabbath. So like later tonight I'm gonna play some Total War, right? But I don't know which Total War I'm gonna play. Does anyone have any recommendations? I got Troy, I got Charlemagne, I got Shogun, I got Napoleon, I got Empire, I got Warhammer. There's a marathon song, is there? I bring up Total War because I'm going to play Shiryama. Which is the Shogun song. I can continue my medieval campaign. You can watch me be a real big noob in Warhammer. Like, I suck at Warhammer, man. I've had to restart it like a bunch of times. You want My Guitar Gently Weeps? Alright, I'll do it after this. I gotta get to Megadeth and Metallica too, man. Like, I'm 1 hour and a half in the stream. There we go. Remember that movie with Tom Cruise? Woo! I gotta do beer? Alright. Don't worry. This song's not 20 minutes long, so I'll get the While My Guitar Gently Weeps. I'll do the Prince version. That has more guitar stuff. I can throw your phone. Listen to that noise. Okay, it's over. It's been forever since I played While My Guitar Gently Weeps. Check out my YouTube version of that one. That's like the best performance I've ever done on that song. That was all like live on stream, because you can see me like mute the mic. Oh man. It's a shame that one doesn't have the most views. What has the most views out of all my guitar videos is like me playing Galneris. And that's only because apparently I'm the only guy that actually played it, and everyone else just rage quit it immediately. And I'm like, I mean, there's worse songs to rage quit. Like, Galneris is... I don't even know if I'm pronouncing it correctly. But I guess, whatever. I got like 5 versions of this. Alright, this is the version I always play, because it's 44 times I've played it. Let's hope it doesn't crash. What's the tone? Alright, we'll go with the tone. So when I played it before, I used my own tone, but let's use the tone that comes with the song. win the award? Oh, thank you, Thumper. It was always fun to play it. Any guys want to hear that? Like, check out the YouTube version of that I did. I still think that that was, like, the best performance I ever did of that song. Top-notch
performance.
And I was lucky to actually upload it to YouTube. There are so many songs I played really well, but I never uploaded it to YouTube. And there are some songs I uploaded to YouTube just because I needed to upload something. And so some of them I'm not the most proud of, but, you know, you gotta make content, right? Now I feel like a game developer. I feel like EA. You know, we gotta release it. No, I feel more like Bethesda. It's like, well, I had to release it. All right. Motley Crue time. Woo! Alright, thumbs. You have a good one, man. You have fun playing golf. VR golf. Golf with friends. Woo! Let's see. The Motleys. Don't worry, I'll redo all the ones that I'm not really, like, too confident in. Like, I did one of Pulse, Comfortably Numb. Oh, yeah. And some of them, are just clips from the live stream. So, like, if I redo them, most of the time, I'll do an actual, like, me just playing it, like, you know, dead silent and in a controlled environment. Because I get, like, comments like, man, this guitar sounds like shit. I'm like, it's not my fault, bro. Like, that was the guy who put the guitar sound in the thing. That's, like, the real tone cable. But, you know, whatever. All right, the Crue time. There's Wild Side. This is the one from Vice City. Might go with Wild Side. I wish I had, whatchamacallit. Check it out too. Yeah, like, comment, and subscribe. Let's get that YouTube. What's it at now? It's like 500. Let's try to get it to 1,000. I always think about splitting the YouTube between streams and, like, videos or, like, games and guitar, but then I'm also, like, I'm honestly too lazy to try and split it up and manage multiple channels. It's hard enough to manage one. Like, it's just easier to just upload it all to just one thing. But I update the playlist, so...
jacket. At work, I'm sorry. It's in my locker.
I know, right? Missed opportunity. I'll do their home
dazzling
sweet home
performance.
One.
I'm on my way.
Here it is. Since we're near the 2 hour mark of the show, that's when I play all the soft stuff. We might not do Metallica. We might do Lynyrd Skynyrd. We'll save Metallica for tomorrow. Hopefully I do a stream tomorrow. I got tonight off and tomorrow off, so. Well, I'm streaming. Hey, what's up, Sutek? How you doing? Oh, there we go. You guys know about the Motley Crue pinball game on the Genesis? It's called Crue Ball. Play some Sonic songs? Alright. Lighters out.
I'm on my way. I'm on my way. Home sweet home. Tonight. I'm on my way. Home sweet home.
You doubled it. Oh, thank you. With only one view. That means only I watched it. Don't forget to thumbs up and make a comment. Like and subscribe. It really helps out the channel. YouTube algorithm's gonna be like, holy shit, he doubled his views in a day. It was Duran Duran that. Oh, you know what? It might be that it doesn't show in other countries. And you're using like a VPN or some shit. I'm sorry, Sutek. I know that happens. Work can be a drag. But you're home now. You're home, sweet home. I just showed off all my Sonic toys. been in journalism? There you go. The TikTok. The TikTok. Yeah, I showed up. I just showed up all
Wonderful
the toys.
Wonderful performance.
But, you know, like, I showed up, like, classic Sonic. He's, look at him, he's all excited. He's excited about this spring. Really, he just fucking loves that shit. On the back, he's even, like, he's like, damn, look at that spring! Oh, I need some J-Dogs! Look, I got Metal Sonic from Sonic 2 as well. Like, look at him on the back. He's like, I need J-Dogs. I got Mighty the Armadillo, bro. Look at that. Oh, he comes with a little Sonic monitor for some reason. Yeah, there. He's an armadillo. But shit. What else? Oh, yeah. Classic Eggman. Jim Carrey as Eggman. He's like, smoking. All right, no, wait. I got another one. I don't believe it. I got Fire Mario. It's me. I'm Mario. Look at you. They're all made by the same toy company. They're really poseable. Kind of nice. They also make the movie Sonic toys and, like, modern Sonic toys, but I'm just collecting the classic series. I had to draw the line. I had to be like, you know what? I can't buy all the fucking... There's, like, 30 Sonic toys. Sonic's like, that's no good. Sonic says... I gotta drop the D. Okay, hold on. We'll do this one first. It's Jax. Jax is the company. They cost like $15 on Amazon, but if you actually go to a store, they're like $9. So they're not that bad. But yeah, they have a Jim Carrey Robotnik. And the movie Sonic toys, if you wanted to collect those. But I wanted the classic. Keep it real, you know? Keep it OG. OG Sonic. Oh yeah, Mike. I was out of tune. I was still tuned for Crew. Okay, here it is.
Oh,
those Sentai shows?
Alright, I'll do Sonic Boom. Sonic Boom's my Sonic Boom, my Sonic song. I was like, I think I was like 7 or 8 or some shit. I had a Sega CD, I fired it up. I was like, wow, what is this? Full motion video, and by full motion, I mean it was like, you know, this big on the screen, and it was really blurry. And Sonic Boom would play. I was like, my god, this is awesome. CD music is the future. Oh, Kamen Rider came before the Sentai show? There was like Sentai shows made just for the States. There was VR Troopers. Anyone remember VR Troopers? I don't even think that was a Japanese show. The Power Rangers, they used like the fourth season of Sentai. Goyu Sentai or whatever? I don't know. After this, I'm gonna do my Phil Collins tribute. Because I'm in drop D, so. See that commercial on, you know what, I'll save it because it'll take forever for me to show that commercial. Like, it took me forever to find that Slash video. There's a commercial for the Street Fighter toys where Guile's like, what's a Dhalsim? And then Dhalsim's foot like kicks him in the performance. Face. It's all live action. Alright, either way. What's a Dhalsim? Alright. We'll do some Phil Collins. Is it D? Okay, yeah, we're good. I'd play the original, but the original is all synth. And the tab kind of sucks, so we'll go with this. For the Miami Vice movie. That Miami Vice remake that no one cares about. You don't like Susu Studio? Oh my god. Hey, you guys know they're making a RoboCop video game? Have you guys seen the trailer for that? It looks pretty rad. Hopefully it doesn't suck. It can't be any worse than other RoboCop games, I can tell you that much. I don't know why I'm talking about RoboCop.
Excellent performance.
Miami Vice. Because this song, the original was in Miami Vice. It was in the third episode, or the pilot. It's the one where Sonny is driving down Miami, and it's really cool looking. It's like, it's all nighttime and shit. You see the lights reflecting off his car and stuff. And he's going to go kill the drug dealer guy. Because the drug dealer guy who killed all the cops, he's one of those like super drug dealers, like they arrested him And they were gonna like convict him, but he got off. And then when he got off, he decided to murder all the cops that arrested him. And so like Sonny and the other cops said, "Fuck it, we'll go rogue." So they throw their badges down, and they get some shotguns, and they get a whole bunch of like weapons and put it in the trunk, and they drive to go kill him. And while that's happening, that song plays. It's, you know what, the RoboCop game is pretty much based off of 80s RoboCop. I don't know if they got the actor to do the voice acting, but he does the line like, "Dead or alive, you're coming with me." Down down on now now, down down on now now, down down on now now now. You know the guy that does the soundtrack for RoboCop's the same dude that does the soundtrack for Conan. All right. What else is in Drop D Americana? I'm getting kind of tired. I might have to find one more song. I might have to retune and do one last song before I leave. But it's gonna be a fucking Metallica medley. Which is... So it'll be like 8 minutes long. Hopefully I can get through it though. I have to skip Megadeth. I made it to Metallica, so here we go. I'll do Metallica doing Merciful Fate. Wait, is this Metallica doing Ronnie James Dio? Okay, cool. That's for that tribute album. Well, there it is. There's the medley. Pulsifier? I don't think so. I've been streaming for like nearly 3 hours. Yeah, 2.5 hours, actually. I guess I exaggerate. I gotta get some food and take a shower. And then I might come back in a couple of hours and play some Total War, some Sonic, or something. We'll see. I might also drink heavily. I might just watch cartoons. We don't know. Like 90s cartoons. Like some Sonic... Oh shit, no, I found some pretty fucked up shit. I found like this... You know what? I'll save it. We'll see. I'll save it. It's funny shit, though. It's almost as weird as that time I found, like, the Sega Hardware Girls. I'm like, why did they make an anime where all the Sega consoles are anime chicks? It's along those lines. Watch though, we're not gonna watch Captain N, because Captain N blows. I've given that show too much of my time. Shit, I might just watch the Sonic fandom. Batman the Animated Series? There's a 2000 remake? Is that just Batman Beyond? Writing in Captain N is so bad. Thank you. I can't deal with it. Way out in Egypt in the Valley of Kings. Well, the mummified pharaohs, they can't get in this sleep. But yeah, don't touch. Or you've been hit by the curse of the pharaoh.
ventriloquist. Hey, you know the weirdest villain in Batman the Animated Series is that little girl that's actually a middle-aged woman. You know what I'm talking about? We'll be right back. All right, that's that. Ah, I guess I'll take my leave. It's what, like a two hours, 40 minute stream. That was pretty good.
Yeah, I gotta wash up, get some food. So I'll be back in like a couple of hours. If I'm not back in a couple of hours, assume I took a nap. I haven't woken up. And then I'll be back in like 1 or 2 in the morning. But hopefully I'll be back in like what is it right now? 7? Hopefully like 9 or 10. Yeah, check out the YouTube, like, comment, and subscribe. I'm gonna try to upload this one. This one probably won't be on YouTube for a couple of days. It depends if Twitch has muted it. And it also depends, like, I also have to like have YouTube go through the songs and cut out the segments that YouTube doesn't have problems, you know, has problems with and stuff. But thanks everyone for being here. Thanks for hanging out. You guys have been a wonderful audience. And hopefully I see you guys later tonight. We'll play some Total War, maybe some Sonic. Maybe I'll just watch crap on YouTube. I don't know, while drinking beer. Who knows? I got the night off. I don't care. I got nothing to do. Pretty good pitch for the show. All right, guys. Have a good one. Take care. I'm out. Oh, my knee.